to make life easier for ourselves, and a lot of the time, there are very simple hacks that we can use to do exactly that. Well, join us now is our very own hack man, John Caldwell. It's great to have you back with us.
Thank you.
We're going to start with something ultra useful to do with this here rubbish bin.
With the rubbish bin. I'm a bit nervous about having a bin near something so beautiful here. I'm scared I'm getting damaged.
Oh,
this is good. This is actually, I know, right? You told me that.
I'll be your Valentine.
Done. This is, I actually really love this one. It's really simple, but I have an issue when I'm carrying the rubbish through the house sometimes where leakage gets on the floor and you've got to clean it up. Really, really simple.
Just pick another newspaper, for the love of God.
Joe. They always get distracted in this segment. You just stick it in the bottom of your bin liner, whack it into your bin. We have the smallest bin on the planet here. Yeah. And that's it, really. That newspaper will soak up any juices or any liquid that is in the rubbish. So no more dripping through the house. Yeah. Really simple.
All right. Works just as well with the Fairfax paper too.
Yes, it does.
Does it absorb more rubbish?
It does.
But bottle of wine and paper towel. What can we do?
Just I know
what I can do with that.
Look, this is we've talked about before how to chill a glass of something. This is when you've got a bottle and you think I need a drink. Nothing cold in the fridge. Yeah. Really, really simple. Paper towel. You need to wet it. This is my makeshift sink here. So a bit of water on the paper towel. Wring it out, and then if you can get it to open up again. Oh. Wrap it around your bottle, like so.
Yeah.
Now, if you stick that in the freezer for 5 minutes, I actually literally did that just before I came on.
Oh.
This was hot, and then 5 minutes in the freezer.
Wow.
It's that's ice, really cold. Ice cold.
That's...
Yeah. You want to touch my bottle? Mm. Joseph. That's the boss's wine.
That's cold.
Yeah, that's coming out of your paycheck. Righto, moving right along.
Oh, sorry, yes. You have a cheap and easy way to make shoes water repellent.
I do. It is cheaper than the water repellent and it is easier. But the other thing is, often when you get your shoes, you don't buy the thing. You think, I'll go out and get that tomorrow, but then you want to wear your shoes, right? And never do it, exactly. A candle, shoes. Oh. So you just do this here. Now, obviously, you're thinking, oh, what are you doing? You're wrecking your shoes.
That's exactly what I'm thinking. I'm not only thinking it, I've just said it out loud.
What, you've wrecked that shoe. But then I have a hairdryer. Watch this. Watch this.
Oh, no.
Ooh.
Oh!
Gone. I mean, just to show you that it actually then does work.
Wow. Look at that.
Straight up. Save yourself $15.
Yeah.
I know.
And next you're going to show us something ingenious to do with freezer ties.
Yes, this changed my life, this one. This is what people's cords look like, right? When you've all hang... And not just for things like phones and iPads and even behind the television, your DVD, TV cords are a bit of a mess. This is so stupidly simple, and since the day I saw it, I've never stopped using it. Headphones are the worst, actually. See, they're tangled
Get
up, right?
Many bags
exactly. Well, you just nicely roll them up, like so. You should have some music for this. And then don't do it too tight because you won't be able to get them off your finger.
So they're also good as temporary handcuffs?
Yes, exactly. Which you need on Valentine's Day. So there you go. How simple is that?
Love it.
And when you do that with all your cords, it really makes a big difference.
Fantastic. And what are these?
This is one I never use because I never have a bag of chips that doesn't get finished in my house. We eat them straight away. Yeah. But if you do, you've had a few chips, really simple. You just get your coat hanger, chop off the ends, give it a roll. If you don't have the fancy pins that you should have, and then whack one of these on either corner. And that will keep those fresh as a daisy.
Yeah.
That's give them a peg as well.
And the great part is that you then get to wear the chips for formal wear.
So you could use a clothes peg as well. Clothes peg would work for that, wouldn't it?
Always, EJ. Yeah, a clothes peg would work just as well. That doesn't look as pretty.
But to have one of these at home, have you got to have stolen a garment? Because when I buy clothes, they take that off and throw it in a bin.
You can keep those. You can ask them to keep them.
Because I must admit, everything I buy it goes to the soundtrack of beep, beep, beep as I run through the door.
Well, come back to your wardrobe in a minute.
This is how the guy lost $1,400 worth of dry cleaning, but his chips are very, very fresh. Now, lastly, separating eggs.
Yes, this is a great one. I love this. This is a party trick.
As a Catholic, I don't actually believe in egg separating. But...
Righto, simple, crack your egg, in you go. Now, a lot of people have all really complicated ways of separating. You just use this little water bottle, push it, please work. There.
Oh!
It did, and then it didn't. On its
Holy
side.
Moly.
That went in there. Is that going to stay in there? Oh!
Done. Wow. Give it a go. give it a go. Okay, okay. It's really that open for those people.
That easy. I'm going to give this to Rocky.
Dun, 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 amazing information. Thank you so much, John. An apology for Joe.
I'm used to it.